motorcycle go over there. Throw out their breeze and board it. Bigger hook on it. See, it works just like in the pulley, you know, the more straps you got, the less weight you know, goes on the cable.
Shirley Wyrick developed the conceptual framework and general visual form of the work, then submitted her proposal in the fall of 1981. By April 1982, a full-scale wooden mock-up was completed. During the following year, the curved reliefs, which are cast in iron, were researched, conceptualized, drawn, and carved in an oil clay or plastiline base. The scale of the work is reflected in the quantity of some of the materials used. More than 650 pounds of plastiline made by the artist and 6,000 pounds of plaster were required. The carved plastiline reliefs underwent a series of transfers through plaster molds to flexible molds, then to sand molds, and finally to the iron castings. By July 1983, all 24 of the iron castings, including 8 10-foot long 3,000 pound midsection reliefs, were cast or in progress, and the fabrication of the sculpture began. Autumn cold followed one of Iowa's hottest summers as a three-person team of welder, artist, and workman cleaned the castings, cut, and welded the steel, and fit the iron castings in the steel shell, maneuvering the increasingly bulky and heavy forms into position. More than 450 holes were drilled, tapped, and countersunk into the steel and iron so that lag screws could hold the outer shell to the interior castings. For structural strength, crossbars were added to the interior of the forms. Finally, joints and screws were welded over, ground, welded again, and ground again to make the forms appear seamless. For 5 months, work seemed endless, with hours stretching into dark, often lighted only with welding rod or grinder sparks.
Oh, my God. Be bad after you've been working a while. Find that.
me in the way of my fork?
Yes. I'll move it. All right.
Okay, I'm back. Okay, it's the other two. It's the other two that we got to move both components.
Got to do with
that. Well, this goes to zero. Let me tell you what's going on.
Oh, here we are.
Each piece is about 6,000.
I'll put on that.
We probably need a double loop, and we'll have to probably double strap.
Right now, we're trying to get this element, this part of the sculpture, into that crib that we built.
Have you got it this way where you want?
Basically, yeah.
One of the most frequent questions I'm asked is, how do you keep going on something that takes so long to complete?
We don't have that right angle. We had a right angle.
All I can say is that I purposely build into the work areas that have to be developed further, areas which are necessary to the meaning of the work. In this work, the reliefs were that area. So every day I work, there is a sense of discovery and search, many decisions to make, problems to solve. And then, too, there's the excitement and anticipation of seeing the work as it really is, when it's actually in place.
Up here is probably about 1,500 pounds a piece. Going from here back is going to be 3/4 of the weight.
For this artist, the excitement and suspense of the installation comes both from seeing, for the first time, the work she only imagined through her drawings and scale models, and in the very real risks involved in handling structural objects built unlike others.
Not straight up and down.
I think so. Got some bars to cut off on the top. The Stefani bars we put on them.
Yeah.
Got the two left here to bolt. The first one's all welded in, ready to fill up and all that paint.
Yeah. It's supposed to snow yet.
I hear that this afternoon. Shirley said that these were going to be up before the snow flies, and we're coming close.
In November of 1983, the four column-like forms were in place, nearly 2 years after the work's inception. To complete the sculpture, all that remained was the careful grading of the earth mound, and this was delayed by a bitter winter and rainy spring. In May of 1984, the work was complete. At last, the artist's vision of steel and earth, joined as one, was realized.
Surely now or never more. The wind in my heart, the wind in my head, the dust in my head.